Welcome to X-Byte On Demand. I'm Ryan Brown.
I'm Corey Fauner.
And we're here today to talk about software-defined storage and hyperconvergence. So Corey, before we begin, can you define those terms for us?
Software-defined storage is basically software that will manage policy-based provisioning and management of data storage independent of hardware. So basically, you used to have to get an appliance that was a dedicated storage appliance. This will allow you to use anything with storage as a storage device.
Okay, so they've kind of taken that special sauce that used to be part of the Equalogic, the EMCs, and turned it into software that you can throw on any real commodity hardware.
Absolutely.
Okay. Very nice. And could for the SMB space, could this replace an Equalogic?
It's definitely an option in addition to Equalogic. A lot of this stuff isn't necessarily meant to exactly replace, but it definitely gives you more options depending on what your budget and your exact needs are. Equalogic still is a great box and a great product, and they're not going to go anywhere anytime soon. But like I said, it just gives you one more path to go down depending on your needs.
Okay, so what are the use cases for an SMB to still use an Equalogic box? Does that exist?
Oh yeah, absolutely. If you're used to Equalogic and familiar with their interfaces, then obviously you can stick with that because that's what you know. Also, if you're already an Equalogic house, you can continue to be an Equalogic house. Another big thing is since Equalogic has been around for much longer than the software-defined storage, if you run into any kind of problem, it's much easier to find a solution to that problem. Tons of people have Equalogic, so you can find 4 or 5 different forum posts detailing your problem and the solution to that problem. With some of the newer cutting-edge stuff, if you do run into a problem, the wealth of information might not be out there, and you'll have to work more directly with the vendor or the creator of the software.
Okay, that definitely makes sense. So for a lot of these SMBs, you may not want to take that chance on the cutting edge technology. You may want that more tested technology out there. We're talking just yesterday also about this, that the RAID controllers. So as you start to scale up a little bit on these on the storage arrays, that the RAID controllers are designed to work in that type of environment when you have an actual Equalogic or EMC box, as opposed to, or even in the Power Vault units, as opposed to the software-defined storage, which really they're designed to work independently.
Yes, absolutely. Like you said, from the ground up, they were all, the dedicated boxes were designed to interface and work well with each other. With the software-defined storage, you're taking several different manufacturers, possibly, and having software manage them to make them work together. So there are benefits to having the controllers able to work together.
Very nice. So in the software-defined storage world, they took that special sauce, as we talked about, and made, okay, now any server can operate as your storage array. And then you still had a different server hosting any of your VMs, any of that environment, doing the compute layer of things. So someone must have said, hey, look, why are we doing these two separate machines? Let's bring them together. And that kind of gave birth to the hyperconvergence.
Absolutely.
And right now, of course, the big virtualization, VMware's big into that. Who else do you see doing the hyperconvergence?
In addition to VM, some of the larger players are Nutanix, Starwind, SimpliVity is another big one. Even Microsoft is getting into the game with their storage spaces direct.
Yeah, we were just at Microsoft Ignite a few weeks ago, I guess at this point, and we saw some of that in action. And a lot of these guys that are talking about doing 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 hyperconverged boxes. Is that the norm? I know we talked about Starwind being able to do it in 2 boxes. We were talking about this earlier, setting up for everything. What do you recommend, and what are the vendors recommending?
A lot of the vendors recommend as a base config 3 nodes. Sometimes that can be a little cost prohibitive. So Starwind actually is one of the only vendors that's can work with 2 nodes to go. So it gives you, again, like we said, another one of those paths to go down. Now, Starwind does recommend that you have 3 nodes for a couple different reasons. You have better high availability and redundancy with the 3 nodes. Also, storage space. If you're running RAID 10 on a 2-node setup, you're only going to be able to utilize 25% of your space. If you throw in that 3rd node, then you're utilizing 33% of your space. So, like I said, 2-node gives you a nice, easy path to get into it quickly. But the 3-node is still the more stable and probably the better option to go with.
Okay, so it's really kind of how much risk your company wants to put into it and how much money they can spend on the option. We're also talking about really with hyperconvergence having two camps out there. There's the appliance camp, and then there's the I want to build it on my own camp. Who do you see? Of course, Nutanix, Simplivity are big in the appliance camp. Who do you see big into the build it on your own camp?
The Starwind is probably one of the bigger players in the build your own camp, and we kind of view it's analogous to Android and Apple with iOS. With an Apple product and iOS, you know you're getting a piece of hardware that was designed to work specifically with that iOS, and it's just going to be fairly simple and it's going to work. Android users more prefer to be able to customize and tinker with things. And Android, as we know, with the scope of the different devices that Android runs on, you can basically take anything and throw Android on it. And it's kind of the same with the appliance-based guys versus the software-based guys. If you want a nice, simple, almost turnkey solution that you know this hardware is going to work with this software, then an appliance is where to go. If you've already got unused hardware and you don't want to buy another box, then, and you don't mind tinkering and setting things up, then probably the software-based hyperconverged is the way to go.
Okay, so it sounds like they're solving two different use cases here. The appliance is for people who really don't want to get in there and get their hands dirty, and probably will also want it very easy to set up. But then the other one is for those who want to tinker with it and more of the cost savings than the taking out any overhead.
Yeah, absolutely. That's with this new technology, especially hyperconverged, again, it's all about having as many paths or options. It's almost a choose your own adventure book of technology.
That's great. And I think that sums it up perfectly. With software-defined storage, any new technology, hyperconverged, it's all about giving choices and having the SMBs and the enterprises out there choose what works best for their particular use case and their scenario. All right, well, thank you, Corey, for joining me today. This is Ryan Brown.
I'm Corey Fauner.
We'd like to thank XBite Technologies, Change Your Servitude, a free trip to the beach with every purchase, or at least it feels like it. They are our sponsor, and we said this last time, by sponsor, we mean they pay our paycheck. So yeah. Thank you very much, XBite. Yep. So this is Ryan Brown, Corey Fauner. Have a great day.